The very first NASCAR race was held on these white sands of Daytona Beach exactly 50 years ago today. Over the years, some of the sport's greatest drivers raced along these slippery shores. Today, those races are just a memory, but the spirit of a race car driver never fades, not for men like Russ Truelove, Buck Baker, Tim Flock, Red Farmer, or Junior Johnson. Buck Baker was the first to win back-to-back Winston Cup championships. Some consider Junior Johnson the greatest driver in history. And two-time Cup champion Tim Flock won four times on the beaches of Daytona. It may only have been sand, but those races laid the foundation for stock car's greatest showcase, the Daytona 500. This super speedway has been the launching pad for NASCAR's most electrifying performers.
Here they come. Waltrip trying to slingshot. Petty is out in front at the line. Waltrip. Petty wins it. And there's a fight between Cale Yarborough and Donnie Allison. The tempers overflowing. They're angry. They know they have lost. Side by side, fighting at the line. Cale Yarborough does it.
What a fantastic strategy.
Cale Yarborough, Ken Squier, can you hear me?
Thank you very much, CBS.
Bobby Allison high. Davey Allison trying the inside move. Bobby Allison holds him off. They come to the stripe, and the winner of the 30th annual Great American Race, Bobby Allison. Davey Allison, his son, in second. Judy Allison is static. What a tremendous family performance.
Oh, I won the Daytona 500. I won the Daytona 500.
Daryl, how long?
Wait. This is the Daytona 500, isn't it?
You bet it.
Don't tell me it isn't. Thank God.
Since the Dale and Dale show has become off of turn four, you know who I'm pulling for. It's Dale Jarrett. Bring her at the inside, Dale. Don't let him get down there. He's going to make it. Dale Jarrett's going to win the Daytona 500. All right. Oh, look at Martha. Oh, dear. Oh, can you believe it? Way to go.
Oh, man. Who will we add to this list today? Will it be the defending champion, Jeff Gordon? Perhaps one of the Labonte brothers who start the day on the front row? Or will it be the man who's had his eye on the checkered flag through 20 years of frustration, Dale Earnhardt? But no matter what happens today, we owe it all to the men who raced on the beach. Legendary racers who will always have racing in their heart.